Good morning, good morning, good morning. Happy day eight, happy day eight. This is your girl, Trell Ravenel, life and marriage disruptor. On this one for day eight, let me get some folks here. Sharing a couple of my groups here. A little later than usual, today is my late day. So I'm on later. And I'm competing with the sun, the moon, the stars, and everything. I have to come into a message to do the live. You guys can see me. Good morning, good morning. Today we're talking about freedom. We're only on here for about 5 or 10 minutes. Freedom, freedom, freedom. So we're talking about breaking the bondage and breaking away from poor behavior patterns and destructive behavior patterns in marriage. I mean, I'm just overwhelmed of the amount of what's going on in marriages, the amount of destruction, the amount of emotional abuse, and many husbands thinking that it's okay to talk to their wives in a vulgar manner, using profanity, belittling them, humiliating them, making them feel useless, helpless, and hopeless. That is not the will of the Lord. The Bible tells us in Ephesians that husbands are to love their wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her. Husbands are to love their wives as he loves himself. And he would not mistreat himself, therefore he should not be mistreating you. A lot of that comes from his pain, his hurt, his unresolved issues that he is refusing to address. He's refusing to address. And what I can tell you is that you cannot all by yourself create a healthy environment. You by yourself cannot turn a bad marriage into a good marriage. So these lives are simply to just share truth, simply to help you all get from the place where you are at in your marriage, where destruction is going on, abuse is going on. I want you to be able to confront the enemy in your husband, confront the issues that has been happening for these months, these years, or even for some of you, decades, have been dealing with these things and have not been able to share your truth in that marriage. And what I want to talk about a little bit today is freedom. Freedom, freedom, freedom. So a marriage that is healthy is a marriage where you are free to be who you are. You should not have to walk on eggshells. You should not have to dumb yourself down. You should not have to create a false character or be something that you're not. You should be able to be yourself without fearing of reprisal. And basically what reprisal is fearing of retaliation. If you say this, he's not going to talk to you. If you do this, he's going to withhold sex from you. If you do this, he's not going to spend time with you or do whatever he agreed to do for you or with you. So in a marriage, you should be able to be free, free in who you are, free in who God created you to be, and not have to conform to something that you're not. You know, Romans 12:2 tells us to do not be conformed to the patterns of this world, or don't be conformed to something or someone that you're not, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Your mind has to be renewed. His mind has to be renewed, and him understanding that I am who I am, and he has to accept who you are. At any time you're in a relationship, be it a marriage or friendship, partnership, or anything, and someone wants you to conform to who they are. And that's Romans 12:1-2. Someone wants you to conform who they are or who they want you to be. That takes away your ability and your creativity to be who you are. So if you feel like you're not yourself, if you feel like you have conformed into a wife that's not you, into a person that's not you for the sake of being married to this person, if you feel like you've had to change your entire demeanor, your entire mindset, your entire outlook on life just to make them happy, that is not a healthy environment. That is not a healthy marriage. That is not a biblical marriage. That is a marriage that is full of destruction and emotional, mental, spiritual, verbal abuse. And you have to say enough is enough. Enough is enough. I will no longer accept who you say I am. I will no longer dumb down my character. I will no longer dumb down my personality. I will no longer dumb down my personality. I will no longer dumb down my mindset. I will no longer conform to your patterns, to your behavior, your systems, your mindset, because that's not who I am. I have to be free of who I am. I have to be free to be me. And the word tells us in John 8:36 that whom the Son has set free is free indeed. So I declare that you are free on today. today, I declare that you are free from the issues, the problems, the mindset, the emotional state that you've been living in for so long, and it's become your reality. And indeed, it is a false reality. God said it's a false reality because it's not who you are. So I declare that you will come out from among that place, and that you say to yourself that enough is enough, that you will be bold enough to say to your husband that enough is enough, that things must change starting today, that you will not go into the new year with the same attitude, with the same mindset, being treated the same way. And if that's less than God's best for your life, you will not go into 2020 being treated that way, because you deserve more. But you have to know that. You have to know that. So this is my minute message. Well, it's been a few minutes, you guys. This is your girl, Terrell Ravenel, Life and Marriage Disruptor. We are on day eight. Tomorrow is day nine. Make sure you're here. I'll be on between 6:30 and 7. I will be on giving you just a message for the day. And I pray that these last 9 days, because we've been on for 9 days, has blessed you. I pray that it's resonating with you. I pray that God is speaking through me to you specifically, and saying that enough is enough. Talk to you soon. Bye.